您现在收看的是华视教育文化频道，
接下来要播出的是字慧与阅读一。
同学大家好，欢迎收看字慧与阅读的课程，我是今天的主讲老师邱怡慧 Florence。 我们在今天会看的是第十讲，是有关于 computer terms。 我们知道电脑科技是非常的发达，所以呢有非常多的字慧产生。我们在上课之前呢，先欢迎 Terry 来到我们的节目之中。 Welcome Terry。
Hi Florence, thanks for having me。
好，那我们现在先了解一下Unit 10里面 Computer Terms 里面的 main idea 是什么呢？我们请 Terry 来帮我们讲解一下。 So could you please tell us the main idea of Unit 10?
Well, in this unit, we see something very interesting in the title, Have You Googled Somebody? We know Google is a search engine, and in this case, they're using it as a verb. We could call this a bit of a computer term. So we'll look at this term and a few others in this lesson.
我们现在先看一下第一段，了解一下里面的内容。
In this first paragraph, we'll have a look at computer technology in people's lives. Computer technology has become a major part of people's lives. This technology has its own special words. One example is the word mouse. A computer mouse is not a small animal that lives in buildings and open fields. It is a small device that you move around on a flat surface in front of a computer. The mouse moves the pointer or cursor on the computer screen. Computer expert Douglas Engelbart developed the idea for the mouse in the early 1960s. The first computer mouse was a carved block of wood with two metal wheels. It was called a mouse because it had a tail at one end. The tail was the wire that connected it to the computer.
好，我们先来看一下里面的第一个单字。首先我们先看一下里面有提到一个字是有关于装置的意思，我们请 Terry 来帮我们念一下。
Device.
So we know we usually use another word, gadget as well, right?
Well, device is a little bit more of a general term describing the use of any sort of maybe machine or equipment to do something, whereas gadget usually refers to something we might have just fun with or something we don't necessarily need.
好，我们刚刚听到了，就是 device 的话是像机器或者设备之类的，那 gadget 的话就是通常是 for fun, 就是可能不那么需要用到的东西。那我们来看一下另外一个用法是跟 device 有关的，我们请 Terry 来帮我们念一下。
Electronic devices.
So what does it mean?
An electronic device is usually something that is electric. Electronic could also refer to something that has some sort of computer technology incorporated in it.
好，我们来看一下，就是这边的话是电子的设备这样子的东西，通常就是跟 computer 有关的这样子一些设备。那接下来我们看一下下一个单字是游标的意思。
Cursor.
我们可以看到这图片上面是有游标的，大家可以看得清楚。然后再来我们看一下下一个单词是荧幕的意思。
Screen.
So we actually use the word very frequently.
We do. Of course, we have many different kinds of screen. We might have a TV screen, movie screen, computer screen. There's all sorts of different uses for the word.
OK, 好，我们来看一下，就是呢，其实有很多种不同荧幕，像电影荧幕啊，电脑的荧幕，或者是电视的荧幕。接下来我们看一下下一个单字是专家。
Expert.
好，再来我们看下一个单字，在课文里面有提到滑鼠的话是有一个尾巴的，我们来看一下怎么念。
tail.
Okay, it also has a different meaning, right? So can you talk about when you talk about the head and the tail when you flip a coin?
Sure. The heads and tails on a coin, the tail just means the opposite of the head. When we have a coin, we have two sides. One is usually a head on it. A lot of coins have the picture of a president or a guofu or something like this. And the other head, the other side is just referred to as the tail simply because it's the opposite. So it doesn't necessarily have a tail on it. It's just the opposite of a head.
OK, 好，我们刚刚是说就是在丢铜板的时候呢，有正面跟反面的。那正面的话就是 head， 然后呢它的相反就是 tail 这样子的字。那通常正面的话，通常都是总统或者是国父的肖像在那个上面。好，我们接下来看一下我们这一段课文的一个大意，我们来了解一下它的大意是翻译成什么样子。首先我们先看一下电脑科技呢，事实上是生活人类生活之中非常重要的一个部分。然后呢，这种科技呢，它有自己特殊的一些单字跟用法，像是滑鼠就是其中一个例子。但是呢，电脑滑鼠并不是居住在建筑物或者是说空地的一个小动物，它是一种 device， 它是一种小小的一个装置。那这个装置呢，是可以让你在电脑前面滑动的意思。所以呢，我们滑鼠呢是可以帮助，就是在电脑前面可以移动这个指标，或是我们刚刚所说的 cursor 的一个用法。接下来我们来看一下是谁发明了滑鼠。我们看到这边的话是说电脑的一个专家，他叫做 Douglas Engelbart。那在这边的话，我们看到这个人他是在60年代早期的时候，他就想到了滑鼠这样子一个 idea， 这样子一个想法。所以呢，其实一开始的时候，第一个电脑的滑鼠呢，是由一块木头雕刻上面加上了两个金属的轮子而成的。之所以会叫做滑鼠呢，是因为在一端我们会看到有一条尾巴，但是呢，这个尾巴是连接到电脑的一个电线。好，同学，我们刚刚在这一段里面呢，有看到一个用法，就是滑鼠发明的时间点是它是用 in the early 1960s。我们现在想问一下 Terry 老师，这是什么意思呢 ？So could you please explain the phrase in the early 1960s?
Sure. In the 60s refers to any time between 1960 and 1969. That would be in the 60s.In this paragraph, we see in the early 1960s, which probably means anywhere from 1960 to 1963. The time is not very specific in this particular paragraph.
Okay, 好，我们刚刚听到了，就是如果你是用 in the 1960s， 那意思就是说从1960年一直到1969年。但是呢，我们在课文里面我们看到的是说 in the early 1960s， 所以呢，有可能是从1960一直到1963左右。那这时间点不是非常的明确，不是非常的 specific。好，我们接下来再看一下下一段，我们看一下还有什么单字，我们请 Terry 来帮我们念一下。
In this next paragraph, we'll find out what a hacker is. Using a computer takes some training. People who are experts are sometimes called hackers. A hacker is usually a person who writes software programs in a special computer language. But the word hacker is also used to describe a person who tries to steal information.From computer systems.
同学，我们先休息一下，等一下再回来看课文。同学，我们刚刚在课文里面呢，有提到了几个单字。首先呢，我们先看一下第一个单字是训练的意思。我们请 Terry 来帮我们念一下。
Training.
So what kind of training does it take if you want to become a DJ?
Well, training usually refers to the experience you need or the education you need to have, or sometimes a combination of both. It can also refer to being shown how to do something. So in order to be a DJ, you would need that kind of training. Somebody to show you exactly what it is you need to do may also require a little bit of education, or sometimes the training you need is just watching somebody do it.
OK, 好，我们刚刚听到了，就是有关于 training 这个字，有的时候是需要一些教育背景，然后呢，有的时候就是去观察别人是怎么样去做这件事情。那怎么样成为一个 DJ 呢？有的时候就是需要融合这两种的一个教育，还有呢观察力在里面，才能做得好。好，接下来呢，我们来看一下另外一个 computer term， 就是骇客的意思。
Hacker。
So it sounds like hackers have a negative meanings, right?
Well, it is a word that has taken on a negative meaning nowadays. We read in the paragraph that hackers used to be people that just wrote computer information or computer language, but the term has kind of shifted in meaning a little bit, that yes, takes on a negative connotation.
好，我们刚刚听到了，就是说呢，骇客，我们在这段课文里面提到的是说，就是他是去写一些程式语言的人，但是呢，今日呢，好像都已经变成一个非常的负面的一个 meaning， 就是有负面的 negative meaning， 就是负面的意义存在的。我们再看回来课文的地方，我们来了解一下这段课文的大意是什么呢？我们可以看到，就是说，如果你要使用电脑的话，事实上你是需要一些训练的。那我们说，像这样子一个电脑使用者的一个专家呢，我们通常就叫做骇客 （hackers）。那通常呢，他这边有提到，就是骇客的话，通常是特别的一个电脑的语言撰写为软体程式的人。但是呢，骇客呢，有时候也会用来就是去叙述，就是窃取系统资讯的人叫做骇客。那我们刚刚有提到，这就是 negative meaning 的意思。我们在课文的标题里面，我们看到的是 computer terms. Have you Googled someone lately? 那我们现在想问一下 Terry, have you Googled someone lately?
Yeah, I think we all Google people from time to time. Usually I'm Googling people that I need to know information about for work or something like that. But of course you can Google just about anybody nowadays and find out information on them.
OK, 好，我们刚刚听到 Terry 所提到的，就是有时候他工作上需要，你必须要 Google 一些人，然后或者是会去找寻一些 information。那我们常常有的时候 from time to time 就是偶尔的时候，我们也会去 Google 某一些人的人名，然后有的时候就是要确认一些事情。好，那我们接下来呢看的这一段课文呢，就是有关于 Google， 我们请 Terry 来帮我们念一下。
In this next paragraph we learn a little bit about that word Google. Another well-known computer word is Google, spelled G-O-O-G-L-E.It is the name of a popular search engine for the internet. People use the search engine to find information about almost any subject on the internet. The people who started the company named it Google because in mathematics, Google, spelled G-O-O-G-O-L, is an extremely large number. It is the number one.Followed by 100 zeros. When you Google a subject, you can get a large amount of information about it. Some people like to Google their friends or themselves to see how many times their name appears on the internet.
好，我们首先呢，先来看一下这段里面呢，有一些单词的用法。那第一个用法呢，是有名的。
Well known，
同学，我们看到这边的中文意思是有名的，但是呢，我们其实呢还有好几个字也是，中文的意思也是一样的，但是它的用法其实是不太相同的。我们现在来问 Terry， So what are some other words for well known？
Sure， we use some other words like famous and noted as well， but there is slight differences in these three terms.Famous, we usually only use when we refer to something like a celebrity, something that everybody in the world knows, usually an actor or something like this. We don't usually use the words famous when we're talking about a restaurant or a food from the particular region or something like that. We would use the word well-known in this case, something that somebody in the area knows about and everybody knows about. The word noted is a little bit less used. It's a little less strong than the previous two. But I think the main thing to learn here is that famous is not used just for anything. It's usually reserved for things like movie stars or famous singers.
好，我们可以听到刚刚的解释非常清楚。首先第一件事情，我们要了解到 famous 虽然是有名的意思，那是中文的意思，但是呢，我们通常是保留给名人 celebrity 或者是说 movie star 这样子的一个用法。那通常是世界知名的这样子的程度，但是呢，我们常常会讲说这是一家非常有名的餐厅，或者是说这个食物非常的有名，我们会用 well known 这个词。那 noted 这个字呢，其实是没有是比较正式的一个用字，但是呢，我们通常还是会用前面这两个单字。接下来我们来看一下有关于搜寻引擎的意思
，search engine。
So what are some of the popular search engines?
Well, I think the search engines that everybody know about are Yahoo and Google, but there are some other search engines such as Bing, that are a little less known.
Okay, 好，我们通常知道的有名的搜寻引擎像 Yahoo, Google, 但是呢，也有一些 less known 的，就是比较没有那么知名的，像是 Bing, 这大家同学应该会知道。接下来呢，我们来看一下下一个单字是非常的，这是一个副词的用法。
Extremely.
So does it mean very?
Yes, it means very, but it's a lot stronger than that. If we use the word extremely, it usually means to an extreme. Of course, extreme means the most of something. So if we're going to use extremely, this is much stronger than just using the word very.
OK, 好，我们听到刚刚是说 extremely 呢是比 very 的程度还要更强烈的。好，接下来我们来看一下出现这个单字
appear.
So how do you use the word appear?
Well, the word appear is used when something comes up suddenly. It usually refers to the fact that it wasn't there a minute ago and now suddenly.It's here. That's usually the context that we use the word appear in.
好，我们现在接下来了解一下我们刚刚所说的这一大段里面的中文的翻译。我们来看一下有关于 Google 的一个用法。那我们刚刚看到这个文章里面呢，它是说另外一个著名的电脑的用字就是 Google， 那它的拼字呢是 G-O-O-G-L-E， 但是呢，它是一个非常网络上面非常有名的搜寻引擎。那一般人呢是利用搜寻引擎是在网络上可以去搜寻资料。我们可以看到成立 Google 公司的这个创办人呢，事实上他会命名为 Google 呢，是因为在数学的程式里面呢，有一个字叫做 Google， G-O-O-G-O-L， 那这个拼字是不一样，意思是指非常非常大的一个数字，无限大的一个数字。那它是多少呢？它是有一个一，然后呢加上100的意思。我们通常呢在 Google 呢是可以搜寻一些资料，那你就是搜寻的时候，你会得到 a large amount of information about it， 就是说呢，会得到大量的资讯。所以呢，有些人会在 Google 上面去搜寻他们的朋友或者是自己的名字，去看看他们的名字在网际网络上面呢是出现了多少次。好，那这是有关于这一段里面的一个大意。我们先休息一下，我们等一下再看一下下一段。好，同学，我相信很多同学都是有部落格，那部落格是我们下一段会讲的一个单字，我们先请 Terry 来帮我们念一下。
In this next paragraph, we find out what a blog is. If you Google someone, you might find that person's name on a blog. A blog is the shortened name for a weblog. A blog is a personal web page it may contain stories, comments, pictures, and links to other websites. Some people add information to their blogs every day. People who have blogs are called bloggers. Blogs are not the same as spam. Spam is unwanted sales messages sent to your electronic mailbox. The name is based on a funny joke many years ago on a British television show, Monty Python's Flying Circus. Some friends are at an eating place that only serves a processed meat product from the United States called spam. Every time the friends try to speak, another group of people starts singing the word spam very loudly. This interferes with the friends' discussion, just as unwanted sales messages interfere with communication over the internet.
好，我们先来看一下里面的单词。首先，第一个单词是包含的意思。
Contain.
Can we also use have or involve?
Sure. Contain means to have something inside of it. So if something contains something else, it means that it's inside.
Okay, 就是包含在里面的意思。接下来我们来看一下垃圾邮件。
Spam.
So what's the definition of the word?
Well, as we saw in the paragraph, the word spam is actually a meat product in the United States, generally associated with being very cheap. And there's a lot of it. And I think the word comes from that, as we just read. Spam means to have something unwanted from the internet, usually somebody who gives out a whole lot of information to many, many people, usually to sell things.We'd call this spam, a little bit like junk mail that we might receive in our real mailbox. Junk email on the internet is called spam.
好，我们刚刚听到就是垃圾邮件呢，其实呢，我们也会用另外一个用法是 junk mail。那 junk 的话就是垃圾的意思。好，接下来呢，我们来看一下另外一个单词是电子的
electronic.
Okay, so what are some of the common uses for the word?
Well, electronic is used any time that something electric or something with a computer is involved. We have been shortening this to just the letter E. So you've probably heard of email or e-boxes, certain things like this. E-readers, we've also heard this.So sometimes we hear it with those words, electronic reader, electronic mail. And these days it's shortened to just e-reader or email.
Okay, and we also learn the electronic devices as well.
That's right.
Okay, 好，那我们刚刚看到电子的这个字呢，其实呢我们已经提过好多次了，就是比方说 electronic devices, 就是有关于电子的这些机器设备的意思。那刚刚 Terry 有提到electronic 话通常我们已经缩写为 e, 比方说 email 这样子一个用法。那在这边的话，我们会看到 electronic mailbox。好，接下来呢，我们来看一下另外一个单词是加工过的
processed.
So what does it mean?
Well, processed in this case, because it's talking about meat, it means that the food has undergone some sort of process of packaging.Or preservation, meaning it's had something added to it a lot of times for these purposes.
Okay, and we also have a processed fruit as well, right?
That's right. Processed fruit might be fruit that has been canned or preserved in some way to expand the longevity of it.
OK, 好，我们刚刚看到的是说加工过的，比方肉类或者是水果之类的。那像水果的话，就是把它做成罐头，比方说 can 这个字 ，can 就是罐头的意思。接下来我们看一下下一个单字是干预的意思
，interfere.
Can you tell us how to use the word interfere?
Sure. Interfere is when we cut into something else, when we disturb.Something else. There's many ways in which we can use it, meaning disturb somewhere, but it's usually used when we interfere in a conversation or interfere in somebody's affairs.
好，那通常呢就是干预到别人的事情这样子的意思。好，我们来了解一下这一大段里面的中文的大意是什么呢？我们看到这课文里面他说，如果呢你在 Google 里面搜寻别人的话，某一些人的话，那你也可能发现那个人的名字呢，事实上也会在部落格上面，就是 blog 这个字。那我们看到这边的话 ，blog 它的意思是说它是一个 weblog， 就是所谓的网路日记的意思。那它是一个 short name， 这边话是说缩写的一个用法。那里面会有什么东西呢？比方说它会包含了 contain 这个字，故事啊 ，comments。Comments 的话是评论的意思，或者是一些图片，或者是一些 link。那我们知道 link 的话，通常我们会把它连接到其他的网站上面。然后呢，有一些人呢，还会每一天去增加，就是在他的部落格上面去 add information， 就是新增资料。如果呢，常常就是有 blog 的人，就是有这个部落格的人呢，通常我们叫做 blogger， 就是部落客的意思。下一段里面呢，我们就要提到刚刚所提到的垃圾邮件这个字。我们看到第一句话是说，部落格呢并不等同于垃圾邮件。那什么叫做 spam 呢？ spam 呢是 unwanted sales messages， 我们看到的是就是你不想要的一些推销的一些讯息，就是会寄到你的电子信箱里面的。那为什么会有这个字呢？事实上它是根据一个非常有名的，就是好笑的一个笑话。那这个是英国的一个电视剧，叫做 Monty Python's Flying Circus。那等一下呢，我们也是会请Terry 来帮我们解释一下。那这句话这边的意思是说，在一群朋友呢，在一家美国的餐厅用餐，那这家餐厅叫做 Spam。那我们看到他说这家餐厅呢，事实上只提供了加工肉类的食品，所以呢，每一次当朋友想要开始说话的时候呢，另一群人就会开始高唱 spam 这个词，所以那这样子的行为呢，就会 interfere， 就是会打扰到朋友之间的交谈，所以呢，像这样子不必要的讯息阻碍了你在网络上面交谈一样的话，那这个地方我们就会用 spam 这个词。好，我们刚刚看到了最后一段有关于 spam 这个字的用法是蛮特别的。那刚刚也提到了另外一个，就是有关于British show。那我们想问 Terry 有关于这个 show。So we just mentioned about the Monty Python's Flying Circus.、Mm-hmm. Have you seen this show before?
Sure, Monty Python's Flying Circus is a British comedy group of people. They did television shows, live performances. They evendid movies at time as well. Very, very popular comedy troupe.
好，我们刚刚看到的就是刚刚听到的就是有关于 Monty Python's， 那他们这是一群就是是喜剧的一个形式呈现出来的。So what about the spam? Because they also talk about the use of the spam.
Right, well the spam, as I said, is a very popular product in America. It's popular because it's very cheap.And it's available at every grocery store. So many people will buy it. And it's kind of a joke about how cheap it is. And that's what they're referring to here.
好，那刚刚听到的就是 spam 的话，它是非常便宜的，就是加工肉类的意思。好，那我们今天呢已经学到了一些 computer terms， 那我们希望这些用法呢，同学其实应该都已经知道了，但是我们借由阅读这些文章呢，可以加深同学的阅读的理解能力，然后多学一些字汇。那我们今天非常感谢 Terry 来帮我们做讲解 ，Thank you very much, Terry.
Thank you.
好，那我们下周见，拜拜。